So this is the image of a typical patient who will be coming walking into your OPD of SCFE. So the primary thing is that he is overweight in the higher percentile of height and weight with an antalgic limb. The main reason we are showing this slide is that predominantly they will have knee symptoms, but they will essentially not have any knee signs. So there will be knee pain, medial knee pain, distal thigh pain, but there will be no knee signs. So therefore, knee range of movement will be pain-free, but active SLR will be painful. Otherwise, the next set of patients which will come to you will be wheeled in, and they will be non-ambulatory. So these are easier to pick up. However, we must always have a very high index of suspicion in all patients with hip pain and chronic limb. And it's very important to diagnose early because the outcome is dependent on the early diagnosis. So all the complications, FAI, degenerative joint disease, chondrolysis, AVN increases if early diagnosis is not made. And a quicker diagnosis is always possible in a non-ambulatory patient with severe hip pain. However, we must maintain high index of suspicion in patients with knee and distal thigh pain too. And obligatory external rotation is the giveaway sign in SCFE. From clinical, we come to radiology. So we'll obviously do the hip, pelvis with both hips, AP first. So there'll be three signs which we need to look for. So at this point, I must tell you that a very obvious SCFE, a severe slip, is obvious to all. But it's the subtle slip which is difficult to pick up. So you require to see a widening or irregularity in the physis. You see a loss of concavity of the head-neck junction and a reduced height of the epiphysis. The most famous Klein's line. So you draw a line parallel to the superior neck and you find that the CFE is slipping out of the Klein's line. The important point here is that if it's not slipped out completely, you compare it to the opposite side and it should be not differing by more than 2 millimeters. Now Klein's line is not useful in valgus SCFE, so ideal X-ray is a frog leg view. So with the frog leg view, we should familiarize ourselves with the Southwick angle. So you draw a longitudinal axis to the, you measure the longitudinal axis of the femoral shaft and you draw a perpendicular to the displaced CFE. And that gives you the alpha angle, and this also helps us classify the slipped capital femoral epiphysis. Another take on the Southwick angle is the posterior slip angle, which actually tells us the same slip magnitude, but there are articles to show that for every degree of increase of posterior slope angle, the percentage of slip increases. The chances of percentage of slip increases. Now, was the frog leg view appropriate? So for the ideal frog leg view, you require to have 54 degrees of flexion and 42 degrees of external rotation. So if you increase the external rotation, you misdiagnose or underdiagnose the SCFE, and if you increase the flexion, then you overdiagnose the SCFE. So to have an ideal frog leg view is very important. So it may be difficult in painful patients, so CT scan is very important. That's the most ideal way of diagnosing the head neck angle, and also the relative femoral retroversion, which may be hidden. MRI tells us about early diagnosis, AVN status, and also about the degree of displacement. Now to quickly classify, acute is all patients symptomatic for less than 3 weeks. Chronic are patients symptomatic for more than 3 weeks with X-ray showing signs of callus formation. And acute on chronic would be somewhere in between, so the patient's been symptomatic for some time and then suddenly becomes more painful. We've already discussed the Southwick angle to 30, 30 to 60 and 60 to 90 degrees, which tell us the severity. But currently the most important is the functional classification, whether the patient is able to bear weight or is unable to bear weight, as the unstable ones have a worse prognosis. Lastly, about the hormonal profiling. So we need to know that though we are tempted to do a hormonal evaluation in all SCFE, it should ideally be restricted to patients younger than 10 years of age or older than 16 years of age, or for patients within 10 to 16 years of age who are not obese. And why is it important? Because prognostically it is important, and we may need to prophylactically pin the opposite side in all patients with endocrinopathies. So final take home is maintain high index of suspicion in patients with knee pain and thigh pain. Do a frog leg lateral view well, otherwise use CT scan, MRI, and focus on hormonal profiling in selected patients.